Chapter 1171, Replenishing Life for the Peacock Tree. These slightly green branches continue to stretch even further while inside the tree, as if they were going through the peacock tree's trunk all the way underground to reach every root. This is. Konkanru was slightly stunned by this. Although a tree father would die and turn into these trees, no one could violate or shake them. Even an immortal emperor would have trouble doing so. But now, Li Kai could control these branches to drill into the tree father's body before going underground. Any spectator would be dumbfounded by the scene. Li Kai closed his eyes. He wanted to use the myriad age tree to check the peacock tree. As a tree father, the peacock tree was an untouchable existence. However, the myriad age tree was different. It was something nearly comparable to the longevity grass. Moreover, Li Kai had no malicious intentions. He was only checking the peacock tree in order to make a comprehensive diagnosis. After a good while, he opened his eyes and told Konkanru, "Let's go." With that, he reached out with his finger. With a buzz, a door was opened. Before she could calm down, he dragged her to a different location. They reappeared at the bottom of the sea in front of an underwater cliff. This was the bottom of Peacock Land. She was shocked once again. Li Kai could freely travel through space while locking onto a coordinate with incredible precision. This was the most frightening and heaven-defying method of travel she had seen yet. At this second, she didn't know how powerful Li Kai was, for his techniques had exceeded her comprehension. Li Kai placed his palm on the cliff, allowing Tao lines to emerge to form abstruse runes. Even a genius like Konkanru couldn't understand them in the slightest. The emerging runes eventually intertwined to form a portal. Li Kai once again pulled the dazed girl into a different realm. She turned a bit silly while standing in this realm. The space inside was vast, as if it was an entirely different world. One wouldn't be able to see the end of this space. Gigantic dragons were dancing in the sky in all kinds of shapes and forms. Some were lying there, others were descending, while more were coiling about. However, upon a closer inspection, it turned out that these beings were not dragons but gigantic roots. These were the peacock tree's roots. However, it was much more majestic than how it was described, because they were simply too large. A few of them shouldered hills of accumulated mud, while other roots even had waterfalls running down from them. When one looked up high, many bright flashing stars could be seen in the sky. These are the peacock tree's roots. She was quite shaken to see this. The tree father had turned into a tree after death, but this world was completely inaccessible to outsiders. It was because these roots were the foundation of the tree father. If they were damaged, the land created by the tree would be damaged as well. Don't be fooled by its magicalness. Li Kai lightly said, "This place is at its end and extremely close to exhaustion. Otherwise, it would be even more magnificent." This reminder made her look twice. At this time, she noticed that these thick and huge roots were quite close to death, while some had withered already. If all of them did, then the tree itself would die. Li Kai walked around these roots and observed every one of them. If necessary, he would cut off a lot of these roots. She followed right behind him as he was making the assessment. She wasn't an alchemist and didn't understand the tree father's situation after returning to the earth. The only thing she could do was follow him and assist if asked. After a careful observation, he finally stood before the main root that was as large as a great mountain. At this time, he opened his fate palace to release the ancestor ginseng, the immortal imagery peony, the 12 transformations dragon silkworm soul grass. After seeing something like a true dragon soaring and howling in the sky, Konkanru stammered, 12. 12. Transformation soul grass. The dragon soul grass had been cultivating non-stop. More importantly, it had absorbed many good items, such as the roots of the phoenix ginseng as well as the pinnacle life water. She was shocked to see all of these immortal grasses. No, they were existences even above immortal grasses. The exquisite valley didn't have any of them. In fact, in the entire heaven spirit world, very few lineages could have immortal level medicines, let alone things like these. These things. She couldn't form a coherent thought at this moment. She finally understood what Li Kai meant earlier about how she couldn't provide the things he truly wanted. There was no need to think any further. She had to admit that few would be able to provide what he truly wanted in this world. He had this many existences even above the immortal level. What other things could actually tempt him? Something like a 12 transformation soul grass was unheard of, let alone seeing one in person. All right, listen up. Li Kai clapped while looking at the happy grasses. Here is a mission for everyone. Go into the main root and inject some essence and vitality into it. Incredible. This is the main root of a tree father. Even the ancestor ginseng commented emotionally while looking at the enormous main root. It took a good look and continued, "This tree father is dying for sure. It won't be easy to save it without spending a massive amount of essence." Li Kai commanded, "Don't worry, you won't do it for nothing. Now try your best." We were waiting to hear those words. The ginseng cheered after hearing this. All of them quickly plunged into the main root. Even for them, replenishing the tree father's life was very difficult due to the great price. However, Li Kai had more pinnacle life water. This was a great tonic for them. "Can they do it?" Konkanru asked. Li Kai smiled and shook his head. "Life replenishment for a tree father isn't so simple. This is only the beginning. We are recovering some of its vitality before carrying out a more drastic measures." He glanced over the other thick roots and said, "Wait until it is a bit stronger. We will have to sever a lot of these roots or else it will die. Can it be done?" She was quite worried. Cutting these roots would be a great loss for the tree, so of course it would be met with resistance. Even though the peacock tree was on the verge of death, it was still an existence that could easily kill god kings even in this state. "It will agree," Li Kai said. If we don't chop off a large number of roots, they will consume more vitality and essence since all of them require these resources for replenishment. Although it won't be easy for it in the beginning after losing these roots, it will be much easier after this hurdle, and I'll save a huge amount of resources as well. She asked, how much time will this process take? It will take some time. You need to be ready for when I ask for help from your valley about certain things. He answered apathetically. For Li Ke, this was not a challenging matter. After all, he had even revived the myriad age tree before, let alone a simple life replenishment. However, there were two different methods for this process. If Li Kai wanted to finish things quickly, he would use the pinnacle life water. That would save him a lot of time and alchemy ingredients. However, this water was too precious to him. He would only use an extremely minuscule amount to act as the leading ingredient for the peacock tree. The true life replenishment would come from the other medicines using a different method. The truth was that Li Kai wouldn't be the only one to think this way. Even if immortal emperors had some pinnacle life water, they wouldn't necessarily use it to replenish someone else's life. It was too precious, much more precious than any immortal medicine. Thus, in order to minimize the amount of pinnacle life water spent, he would have to utilize a slower method.